Bake and Cook Studio. Today I'm going to share recipe of eggless croissant. Now let's start our recipe. Now we are making croissant, so it is very buttery bread and it is served in continental bread. Let's start our recipe. I have taken 500 gram of refined flour, that is you call it maida, 15 gram of yeast, 10 gram of salt, 25 gram of sugar, 30 gram of butter, and of course 250 ml of warm milk. To start with the recipe, I have taken a warm milk in a mug or any kind of measuring jug you can use. Now why I'm taking warm milk? Because I am using dry yeast. If you have fresh yeast, then you can go for chilled milk. I'm going to add that yeast, then salt, then sugar. I'm going to blend it. We have to blend until sugar dissolves, and then we'll cover it for 5 minutes until it gets bubbles on the top. Now you can see bubbles are coming on top. It means our yeast is thoroughly fermented and it is ready for adding to the flour. Basically jo dry yeast hai, that is inactive, you can store it at home and it is easily available in the market where all the bakery stuffs are sold. So you can go and you can store it in your home whenever you want to use for making bread or any kind of bread products. You can just add warm water and other ingredients which I have mentioned in it and you can activate it. Now I'm going to add this yeast mixture into the flour and I'm going to knead my dough. I will add butter as well. The purpose of adding butter into the flour while making dough, it will stick, it will help to stick the butter which I am going to laminate on the dough. So this is very useful when we add butter into it. Just stretch the dough and make it soft as much as you can. It takes hardly 5 to 7 minutes to make a dough. Our dough is ready. Now we are going to rest it in the fridge for at least 30 minutes to make it cool, because we are going to apply butter on it. So our dough has to be chilled one so that butter doesn't melt. Fridge. I'm going to roll butter which I'm going to laminate. I have taken 200 gram of butter, so the butter which I have taken, that has to be soft, not very hard and chilled. So we have to just roll it and make a sheet of the size of the dough, right? We have to roll it in a rectangle as much as possible. We have to try it to make it rectangle. After rolling this, we have to just make a shape of rectangle and we are going to chill it in the fridge. Meanwhile, keep dusting the flour on the bottom of the dough so that it doesn't stick. I have taken dry flour along with this. I'm going to dust it on top of it and roll it. We have to try to roll it in a rectangle shape so that we can cut our croissant nicely and nice triangles. I have rolled the dough in a rectangle sheet. Now I'm going to place butter which I have chilled in the fridge. I'm going to place it in the center. Now you can roll it little so that it sticks. You can remove it like this. You can spread it to make it little wide with the help of spatula. make it equally spread. It should be equally, similarly spread over it, which is going to, you know, give a flaky texture to the croissant. The more it is like this, now change the side, touch the flour and again start rolling it. Now we are going to like this. Now we'll place this into the fridge for again 15 minutes to give it resting as well as getting butter to. Again, I have rolled the sheet in a rectangle and I'm going to do book folding like this. Same way. Again, same resting for 15 minutes in the fridge. Like this. Roll dough in the fridge for 15 minutes for resting. Slit like this so that you can spread it wide and you can make a corner, right? Now we're going to place little dark chocolate chips. Instead of chocolate you can use cheese also, grated cheese, like this. Place it, then start rolling. Guys, if you have it with tea or coffee, it goes yum and your children would like it. You can stuff any kind of savory stuffing also. Savory matlab ki aap usko paneer wagaira aisa kuch bhi variation kar sakte ho. Chamber, otherwise you know you can place it near your gas stove or near your oven, because we have added yeast into it and it is going to proof, and the more it proves, it will be very soft and flaky like this. There is one more shape which I'm going to teach you now, that is real croissant shape of crab, right? So how we make it? There is one shape which I showed you now. Now this is another one. You are going to stretch it little to make a sharp edges like this. Then like this, turn it. You can stretch little to make more, you know, layer. Now our croissants are ready. We are going to place it on the tray. Our chocolate croissants are absolutely proof. Now we are going to apply milk wash on it so that it gets golden brown color. After that, we will bake it at 200 degrees centigrade.